Hey everyone, this is Brandon with Freeman's Construction. I'm here with Greg from Waples Construction. We're out here in Ramona at this new custom home that we're building. We're actually installing a new cornfield right out here in this field behind us. So we're switching gears a little bit today. So I hope you enjoy it. Just kidding, we got an alternative septic system going in this place here. So Greg's gonna take a few minutes and just explain why we do that and how it works. So let's take a look. All right, so we are over here at the septic tanks where this system begins. So Greg, can you kind of tell us what's going on here with this?
Yeah, absolutely. So the reason why we're doing this setup is because it's a little bit different over here. This area kind of has a lot of high groundwater, so a regular conventional system won't work. So they allow us to do these a little bit more shallow, closer to the surface. So let me go ahead and walk you through how it works here. We got our main line coming into the first part of the septic tank here. The solids settle out, make their way over into this middle chamber here where there's an aerator that stirs it around, keeping the solids to the sides. After that, flows on out this way, out of this tank, and into this tank. Now in this tank, there's a pump down here with a few floats on them, and they work to actuate the pump on and off once it gets to a certain level. And from there, we come up and we pump out to our dispersal field.
Let's see if we can trip going through this here.
So this is our dispersal field here. As you can see, we got numerous lines in here. So how it works is it comes from that pump and comes in the first line, drops all the way down to the end, comes back into the return line. So it'll do that all the way through this 40 feet or so here. Out one, return on another, all the way down. And over here at the end, and also right here, we'll have a couple air locks, and that's to keep air from purging in the system, from blocking it from getting all the way to that end. So it's approximately 2,200 feet of drip line. This line looks similar to standard irrigation drip line. However, it's slightly different for this application. So you can see every 2 feet, there's an emitter where water is forced out via the pump. All right, so here's the special fittings that we use and the pipe that we use. So it just goes on just like that, twist locks out. Now that fitting is secured to the pipe. And here's the little emitters that are every 2 feet on here. I don't know if you can see with that line there. There's the other side right there, tiny little hole.
So where that hole, that's every 2 feet?
So these are every two feet inside the trench here.
Uh-huh.
And that's where the water disperses via that line through the pump there. So every 2 feet, all the way down and returning all the way back as well.
And the pressure is pushing those?
The pressure's pushing water back through that, yes.
Got it.
So it runs all the way through here, and then anything that doesn't get pushed out into the ground goes back through that return and back into the septic tank.
So is that first tank over there, does it kind of function like a traditional septic tank, you know, within reason?
Yeah, pretty much. So everything goes in there, the solids kind of settle out, and then liquid makes its way over into that second tank where that pump is at. And then from there, runs through this PVC here into this distribution valve, and it starts working its way out into the leach field. It starts right here at this first one, goes all the way to the end, comes back, returns. All the returns end up going that way. The second one comes in through here, all the way back to the return, all of them going that way. So every other one will be a pressure line, and then it'll come back with the other side and return all the way back. So there's 20 lines in here, so 10 of them feed and 10 of them return. And so that's pretty much the standard on these, they call them drip systems here.
So does that, the return line, does it pump it back in to the first tank or the second tank?
So the return line goes, flushes it all the way back into the main tank. And the reason being for that is any mud or contaminated water doesn't go straight back into the pump chamber. It goes back into the main tank so it can settle out before going back into the pump chamber. All right, so this is where the water comes through, and it'll go every single other one of these emitters here out. There's one here, and it'll be on the next one here. Half of them are return, and half of them are pressure out. These are those connectors that we were showing you earlier. That pipe just goes right onto the end of that, and then back onto the main tank.
Yeah, these systems are really cool. This is the first one we've done on a home that we've built, but it really gives the homeowner some options because whether there's not space to do a typical traditional septic system with leach lines, or like here where there's high groundwater. Also, you said where people are putting in ADUs.
Yeah.
Either like sometimes they just wouldn't even be able to do it, but they can put in one of these, right?
Either not enough room. That's the majority of it. I mean, there is a lot of these groundwater issues, but a lot of it is there's just not room for two conventional systems, plus each one would require 100% reserve.
All the reserves, yeah.
So there's just not a lot of room around here, and these things make it happen.
Right on. All right, so I'm out here in the drip field, also called the leach field. This is where all those black emitter pipes are running through. We had, there's 10 pressure lines and 10 reserve lines. We got, I believe it's 4,500 square feet of leach field here. So we have that here, and what we're required to do when we're building these new homes is we have to have 100% space for the reserve. So you can see behind me here, this is where this is going to be. This is all figured out. I'm gonna watch myself there. I'm gonna end up getting smacked in the head by a branch. But anyways, we have to have 100% reserve. So 4,500 square feet. If this ends up going bad, the original leach field, we have to be able to replace that. So that all has to be figured out before we even start the home, before we even break any ground. So this will all get, these trees would have to go and all that, which isn't ideal, obviously, but this is where it would go for the reserves. All right, so we're out in the cornfield here again with Greg from Waples Construction. Thank you for showing us what's going on here.
Absolutely.
And how the system works, and thanks for doing a great job. So I hope you learned something today about these new alternative septic systems that we're putting in. So if you'd like more information about building a custom home or remodel or building an ADU, you can head to our website at freemansconstruction.com, and we'll see you next time.